my heart.
I feel like I don't want to put my feet on a carpet.
It's okay.
I think it helps a lot that it's staged.
To see, yeah. To
yeah.
definitely see how you can fit everything.
Yeah.
But this is a queen size, so it's still a good size. And you still have space to maneuver. But I've definitely seen different tenants' apartments, and everybody does it different. Completely different.
Hey.
Hello. Ah, shit, Femi. It's kind of cold today, so I got on a hoodie. She has on a coat.
I have my coat here.
We just came from looking at two apartments. The second one was good. The second one had bigger areas, bigger rooms, walk-in closet, dishwasher. Could do laundry inside the apartment. So that was cool, you know? It's just that the kind of people that we are, our walk-in areas doesn't suit our lifestyle. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We walk. Okay, so we look at the two apartments, like Baby said, and then we walked all over downtown LA.
Right.
On purpose. We wanted to, because we've been Ubering, but we wanted to purposely walk around downtown LA to feel it out. And we're still downtown LA. We decided to eat here. But, the homelessness?
Yeah. People told me to look up. I didn't think it was like I thought it was bad. I mean, I think that it probably gets worse if we walk certain places. But
there's certain, like where we are right now is actually pretty nice.
Right.
But what we had to walk through to get here
was gang.
Was gang. It's quite alarming, actually. So, yeah. So this is our day. But it's our third day here, but this is like day two of, what's today?
Wednesday.
We got out here yesterday?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Well, it's day two, so.
Okay, so this is day two.
Yeah, we're definitely not coming downtown LA.
No, we're
after
done.
After today, it's going to be Beverly Hills, Rodeo.
Beverly Hills, all the tourist spots. We just went into
Hollywood Sun.
Yep.
All that.
And we see more apartments Saturday.
Yeah.
So we'll edit the vlogs together probably to have all the apartments in one, or probably just put the apartment, you know. So we record it a little bit so y'all can see, but yeah. So we just wanted to let y'all know how we were, because y'all know that we're out here to feel the vibe.
Right.
So far, as far as moving goes, if I was to make my decision today,
it'll be a no.
It's definitely a no. Only because downtown LA to me was supposed to be more like
42nd Soho vibe.
Not really 42nd. I didn't think it'd be like 42nd. I thought it would be.
I think if it was less dirty and less homeless people, it would be.
It would be perfect. But it seemed really run down.
Yeah,
it seemed more run down than I thought it would.
It's not a lot of renovations going on.
It's a lot of homeless
people. You can you see one every 5 seconds. You're gonna run into a homeless person. So
if you're like walking, like if you're in a car, I'm assuming you're fine. But no, you still, I don't know. So yeah, that's how we're feeling.
It's giving me African vibes because
you said that when you got out here.
Yeah, the rich people live in Bel Air, Hollywood, and then the medium class live in downtown LA.
This don't really feel like middle class though.
Yeah, and this is the rundown. Downtown LA.
I think because I watched a lot of YouTube videos, and I think I remember someone saying that there isn't a middle class. There is like a lower class, and then it's upper class.
Mm.
Because I thought downtown LA is the middle class where we can live, and live near and walk around. It do seem middle classy, but with a lot of homeless people.
With like, the lower class, yeah. It's middle and lower here.
Yeah.
And lower.
And I don't feel comfortable walking around. I don't know. So, but I didn't think that I didn't think I would live in Beverly Hills. You know, like I don't want to only be comfortable in Beverly Hills. I wanted to be comfortable downtown LA. And this area is cool. You know, like we're in a cool area. But we just walked through this. We just walked through some shit. Okay. We thugged it out just now, a couple blocks away. I was like, you know, everybody was like, sus. But yeah, that's it. That's how our day two is going. And we'll keep you updated with this trip.
Yeah. Def.
While we continue to walk.
Tomorrow and Friday is going to be like real fun.
We're going to try to do a 6-day vlog. Yeah. So I hope y'all watch our day one. Y'all watch our day one. You know what? Just pause this right now and go watch our day one.
Yeah, I want you to pause that. And then when you come back, you can fast forward.
Look, I'll pause it for you.
I paused.
I
froze my smile.
It's so cool. What do you feel about LA, babe?
She has been very. With me, I've lived in Africa, so I'm down for whatever.
You a lie because you was like, I ain't
feeling. No, I don't want to live there. Like the first two apartments, I could stay there because like I've lived a single life.
Oh yeah, the apartments were nice.
When before I met you and coming from where I am, I've slept on the floor before. So when you're telling me that we can move out here in a crib, I don't care where we are. You know what I'm saying? I'm always.
Babe, don't say you're okay with living in a gang area or a sus area. I'm not saying gang area.
When you met me, I lived in the Bronx.
You keep saying that. I understand that, but. Where we just walked through, you will live there?
No,
but that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Don't say that because you just came from Ghana or you live in the Bronx when I met you that you're okay with living there. You're not.
Yeah, if we're gonna move from Columbus up from New York, we wanna.
That's the thing. I was born in Brooklyn, yes. However, I moved to the city when I was 12. You know, so I live in a building that was really nice in a neighborhood that's really nice and safe. And not to say Brooklyn is not nice and safe, but it was just two totally different worlds. And I must say that I'm accustomed to that area. So if I am in an area that look a little sus, I don't feel as safe as I would in a neighborhood that I grew up in. That's just fact. Because even with me walking around downtown LA, I was like, damn, am I bougie?
You are bougie. Y'all bougie with the little gang, but it's not gang, raggedy.
I don't think I'm bougie, but if this is hood for me, then yeah, I must be bougie.
Who texted
me? Who texted us?
That story is crazy.
We're actually right across the street from Rita. If Rita was to transfer her job, she would be working right here. So it's interesting that we just happened to stumble upon a restaurant that is across the street from my baby would be working. Yep, but that's it. That's the verdict right now, y'all. And we done heard 85 different cars with Nipsey playing Nipsey. Don't you love it?
Yeah. Hey.
So I haven't had a burger.
I
haven't had a burger in probably over a year.
That is?
Remember when I met you used to eat a damn burger all the time?
Yeah, I used to make you one from my old job at McDonald's.
But I haven't had a burger in a long time. I don't like the way I feel like I'm eating cow. Although I am eating cow, it's like I'm really eating a cow. Anyway. But I ordered a mini burger, so I'm excited.
Waiting for the food?
Yeah.
Where? This one has been so affectionate. Like, she's been all over me, kissing me, touching my boobs and all that. Trying to grab my ass this morning.
I don't try to. You walk around naked all the time.
I don't walk around naked.
You walk around naked all the time.
I always got clothes on. I'm embarrassing.
You walk around naked all the time. You love it.
We're gonna try and eat.
Yes.
Compile some videos. We're gonna keep vlogging.
We're gonna put them together for y'all and hope y'all enjoy our day two vlog. HR Squad. But you gotta cut it off if you want that side.